59, 11, 5, and 3 in 1982. From then, it was zero all the way until the bronze medal of Ryan Papa.
And Mr. Papa.
And okay. Ryan trained in the U.S. Okay. on his own initiative.
So not part of the PASA system, if there is even a system to speak
well,
of. And so zero medals since 1986.
Yeah. Now,
but Senator, yeah. let me ask you a question, okay? So PASA was incorporated. How did these guys, in the first place, come to be at the helm of this association, this organization?
Well,
is there a voting process? Is there
they
elections?
Applied with FINA.
Okay.
And FINA recognized them.
Okay.
As the association for swimming in the country. And maybe at that time, there were no other associations.
How often are the elections for the officers of PASA? Is it every year, every 3 years, every
Well, that's the
years?
Thing. They have not really had any decent elections.
Okay.
So that it makes a mockery out of the entire system.
But,
you
but
see.
According to the charter, how often should they have, how often should the leadership rotate, or how often should the vetting process be held?
Well, I think they should have elections every year.
Okay.
At the maximum, every 2 years, no? But the strange thing is that that year, I remember that they were discussing this. It was an Olympic year. So they said, okay, para wag tayo magulo, let's just wait until after the elections. So that after the Olympics, we will have elections, di ba? Para it's not nakakahiya naman because it will end up we might not be sending anybody there. So to this date, those honest to goodness elections have not really been held.
Who participates in the election? So you have an NSA, yeah. and then who votes for Mr. Joseph or the other officers?
They have a roster of members
okay.
that should be eligible for
PASA
voting.
Members.
PASA members.
Okay.
And
These associations around the country or individual people?
Oh, these are done. They're selected by region.
Okay.
See, because as an NSA, you're supposed to have
chapters
okay. in every region.
Okay.
And you're supposed to actually be developing young swimmers, and you're supposed to be on the lookout for swimmers who may not be your members, but they are swimmers nevertheless. And you should be on the lookout for them so that they will represent the country to win medals instead of being kulelat.
Yes. No, so there's representation per region, and these people who represent
should be voting
region,
for them. I really don't know how they manipulate things or they go about their business. All I know is it's just been Mark Joseph and Mark Joseph and Mark Joseph
yes.
and until the other PASA members bolted out of PASA because of the non-liquidation of the 34 million pesos that was given by PAGCOR directly to PASA without passing the PSC, right? So these parents and swimmers and coaches said, hey, wait a minute, how come PASA was given 34 million, and then PASA.
That doesn't seem right. I mean, according to the charter, it's supposed to be the PSC who to receive the money from PAGCOR, and the PSC will be the one to disburse.
Yes. So
very irregular.
And at that time, Ephraim Henwino was the chairman of PAGCOR. He gave the money to Mr. Joseph through PASA, and Mr. Mark Joseph conveniently transferred these monies to Trace College, which is a college owned by Mr. Henwino.
So it seems that the money pretty much went in a loop.
Like a return to sender.
Return to sender. Now, ma'am, okay, and zero medals since 86 and all these unliquidated this,
yes.
unliquidated that. How are they
in
able
Asian
to,
Games,
to...
In the Asian Games.
Yes, I mean, to stay in power and at the helm of this organization for so long.
Well,
I mean,
that's just the thing, you know. I mean,
Shouldn't the swimming clubs around the country be up in arms and demanding a change?
Oh, but they're not able to do that because they get bullied. The people who are demanding a change put up their own organization called ASAP, Aquatic Sports Association of the Philippines. Right after they put up ASAP, Mr. Joseph changes the name of PASA to Philippine Aquatic Sports Association because ASAP was organized, you know. And then he has now this rule which has always been arbitrarily implemented, that if you are not a PASA member, the PASA coaches are never allowed to train you if you are not a PASA member. So if you're a public school student, not a PASA member, you cannot be trained by a PASA coach.
Or swimmers belonging to your school.
Or swimmers belonging to our school.
Like the best female breaststroker in the country.
Oh, you're not allowed to do that. So the PASA coaches are only allowed to train PASA members and non-PASA coaches, no matter how good they are also not allowed to train PASA members. Non-PASA coaches are not allowed to train PASA members.
All this sounds very counterproductive.
The worst part of that is non-PASA swimmers are never allowed to swim in the same pool as PASA swimmers, whether for a competition or for any kind of event. I know, because when I invited the PASA members and swimmers, parents, coaches, officials, through Louis Mangahis, their vice president, who came to visit us in Diliman Prep School, he told us that they're not allowed to attend our barbecue, just a social event, in our school, because PASA members are not allowed to even speak to non-PASA members.
This is crazy. Ma'am, we have to pause for a break, but hold that thought. Hold the PASA in your thoughts for a moment.
Yeah.
And guys, don't go away, because in a few moments, Philippines Uncut and amateur swimming in the country will return.
It's really...
Oh,